Media outlets and journalists play an important role in shaping the narrative around HIV decriminalization. Here's ways to tell those stories responsibly. In the 1980s and 1990s, it was impossible to escape stories about HIV. It was a time when so many things were negatively impacting Black communities, including the crack epidemic and the war on drugs. Science was still learning about HIV, and the media was communicating what they knew when they knew it. Not always in the best interest of people living with HIV or the Black community. Biomedical advancements in HIV treatment have shifted the conversation about HIV from one that centered death to one that should be centering living and thriving. Oftentimes, we find our media outlets and journalists struggling to catch up to how much things have changed. Did you know that we have a medication that, if taken as prescribed, is 99% effective at preventing HIV? Yep, it's known as PrEP. Pre-exposure prophylaxis. Anyone who is sexually active or engaged in injection drug use can talk to their medical provider about PrEP. And no, I am not just talking about members of the LGBTQIA+ community. PrEP is for everyone. Did you know that we have a medication regimen that, if someone believes they've been exposed to HIV, that they can take? Yep, it's a thing. It's called PEP. Post-exposure prophylaxis. PEP can be used in emergency situations within 72 hours of possible exposure to HIV. And to be clear, this is just on the HIV prevention side. Let's talk about the fact that someone living with HIV, who is virally suppressed, also known as undetectable, cannot transmit HIV to their sexual partners. I am not making this up. According to the CDC, people who get and keep an undetectable viral load or remain virally suppressed can stay healthy for many years and will not transmit HIV to their sex partners. Can prevent. Can stay healthy. Will not transmit. The conversation about HIV is not the same one we had 30 years ago. Heck, it's not even the same one we were having a decade ago. We need everyone to know that. With all of these amazing advancements in HIV treatment and the fact that we've already discussed that HIV criminal laws don't align to science and haven't been proven to prevent HIV, it's important that our journalists and media outlets report responsibly on HIV criminalization cases. Here's a few ways to do that. Don't treat stories about cases centering criminalization based on HIV status as shocking, surprising, or big news. It's often tempting to appeal to the lowest common denominator for clicks and likes, but it further stigmatizes HIV and doesn't open up the conversation about why HIV is being criminalized in the first place. History won't reflect positively on stories told this way, especially as more advancements in HIV treatments and prevention become available. Don't use stigmatizing language when reporting on stories about HIV. One thing you can do, replace HIV positive or HIV infected with person or people living with HIV. It's a way to center the people you are reporting on and not the illness. We call this being people first. Build relationships with your local HIV services organizations to weigh in on stories about people living with HIV before you need them. HIV is something we should be talking about with the same regularity as diabetes and breast cancer. It's a part of all of our lives and not something that any community can ignore. When reporting on cases that criminalize HIV, also report on the facts about these laws, how they were implemented, and who they impact. It'll help your audience to better understand HIV criminalization in your community and how it negatively impacts people living with HIV. Last but not least, pitch stories about people living with HIV. Living with HIV. Tell stories about their lives, their histories, and their work in your local communities. These stories can go a long way to reduce HIV stigma, but also change hearts and minds as we fight to modernize HIV criminal laws. This isn't an exhaustive list, and I am not a journalist, but I am a consumer of news. I can tell you the way that a journalist or media outlet approaches a story is either going to bring me back to your publication or your website or turn me away. In our current climate, you likely want everyone taking in your content. CMP believes that HIV criminalization laws demand reform. We are part of the Health Not Prisons Collective. To learn more about our work around HIV decriminalization, visit bit.ly/CNPHNP. Oh, and get involved in your state's efforts to decriminalize HIV. They can use your support. And by the way, once you find out who they are, just go ahead and pitch that story to a media outlet. See? You hung around to the end and you got a slam dunk story idea. Peace.